Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to do another numerical based on different data, and we on that will calculate what would be the standard Gibbs free energy change in that manner, as well as we'll predict that what will be the spontaneity of that particular reaction. So let us do that. So friends, this is a numerical where we have to calculate the delta S surrounding, that is the change in entropy of the surrounding for the reaction at 298 Kelvin. And the reaction has been given as carbon dioxide plus 6 moles of H2O, basically hydrolysis of carbon dioxide. In this case, C6H12O6 plus 6 moles of oxygen has been produced. So in this case, basically, what we have to calculate, we have to calculate the delta S of surrounding, and in this case the delta G naught is also been provided to us, that is the standard Gibbs free energy change, which is being given as 2879 kilojoule per mole. And talking about the entropy, the standard change in entropy, it is also been given as, and that is delta S naught is equals to minus 210 joule Kelvin per Kelvin per mole. So in this case, we have to calculate the delta S. How that can be calculated? Because we know that the delta S has a relationship with the change in enthalpy, that is delta H, as well as the temperature. So in this case, the first thing that we are going to predict is that what would be the value of the standard enthalpy or change in enthalpy, standard change in enthalpy. So that is what we have to calculate. So now here what we have, this is the value that we have. So let us predict what would be the value of delta H. So in this case, the first thing that we have to find is the value of delta H naught. So in this case, we know that the formula for delta G naught will be nothing but, that is delta H naught minus T delta S. Again, this are in a standard states. So therefore, G naught is equals to delta H naught minus T delta S naught. So in this case, the G naught has been given to us, that is the standard Gibbs free energy change has been given to us, and it is mentioned as 2879 kilojoules per mole. So therefore, what I am going to do is I am going to convert it into joules. So now here it has been present in joules, and the value of delta H naught is not known to us, so therefore I'll keep it as it is. And in this case, the temperature has been given as 298 Kelvin, and the standard Gibbs free, the standard entropy has been given to us, it is minus 210 joules per Kelvin per mole. So this is what they have provided to us, and the temperature has also a unit of Kelvin. So in this case, we could easily predict what would be the value of delta H. So therefore, the delta H naught will be nothing but this whole value, that is 2879 into 10 raised to 3. And in this case, as we could see that the minus into minus, it would be plus, but if it goes over there, so therefore this will be again we become minus. So therefore, the thing that we are going to do is 298 multiplied by 210. So therefore, this is the thing that we are going to do, and let us see what is the answer we could get. So we got a value of, that is 2816 into, I could write it as 420 into 10 raised to 3 joules. So this is the value of delta H naught that we have got. So based on this thing, we could easily calculate what would be the value of the delta S surrounding. So that is what they have asked us. They have asked us to calculate what will be the value of delta S surrounding. So for that, we know that delta S surrounding, or we could say it as the change in entropy of the surrounding, is equals to the minus delta H naught, or usually for the system, it would be minus of the delta H naught divided by the time that divided by the temperature that we have. So therefore, we have the delta H naught is equals to, that is what we have got as 2816 into 10 raised to 3, basically 4.20 into 10 raised to 3 divided by the temperature that we have, and the temperature that they have given to us is, that is 298 Kelvin. So therefore, this is nothing but 281.642. So therefore, we'll do this thing and let us see what is the answer we could get. So we have got a value of, that is minus 9.45 into 10 raised to 3, that is joules. So this is how we have predicted and how we have determined the value of the delta S surrounding by using the value of the standard enthalpy as well as the standard entropy that they have provided to us. It was very much simple to do. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you will do this kind of numerical more and more so as to make yourself best in this kind of numericals. And share this video with your friends and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.